Hi everybody, I'm Russ with ESBService.com, and today I'm going to show you how to convert from a 4-lamp open style ballast on your ESB tanning bed to 2 separate 2-lamp RT ballasts. Now, for this demonstration purpose, we have the bed with the cover already off, and your perspective is looking from the rear of the bed where the power cords come in. So to start out, I recommend having the bed unplugged for at least 2 hours before touching anything, and of course having it unplugged while you're working on it. Let's say this is the ballast that's failed and you need to replace. What we would do first is just simply remove the power connectors. We got the 8-pin harness, there's another 8-pin harness, and the power connector, and yours might be white and black. So, now there's only 2 screws holding the ballast in at the base on the metal plate here. I'm going to remove those. Let's set the ballast aside. Now, the RT ballast kit will come with 2 ballasts like this. It could even come with one single ballast that has basically 4 red wires coming out of the end. This example here shows 2 ballasts that each have 2 groupings of 3 wires, but they end up terminating to 1. The point is you have 4 terminations at the very end of whatever ballast configuration and harness configuration you have. You're always going to end up with 4 terminations here. These 4 red wires are going to go into your lamp holders here once we remove this harness. But I wanted to explain the possible difference in between variations of the ballast that's supplied with the kit. They all would work just fine and are electrically the same. They come in different variations, basically. So I'm going to set this aside for a second, and I'm going to remove the harness by taking a straightened paper clip and inserting it into the. There's a slot in the lamp holder for it to release, and you just simply push it in there, and it releases the wire. There's no cutting or splicing here. So we just release all the wires for the, actually for these as well, because we got 4 lamps to do. Okay, and then we'll go to the other side of the bed and do these 4. So when we're done with this, we're just going to take these harnesses and just remove them entirely. They're no longer needed. All that we're going to still use is the power connector, the bipin with the black and the white. Okay, there, now it's completely removed. Start first by mounting these ballasts onto the ballast support frame here. In your kit, you're going to have 2 brackets, or a couple of U-shaped brackets, and these are just going to hold each ballast next to each other on the frame. Now, I'm going to take 2 screws from the kit. And I'm going to see where these holes can line up that are already in the ballast frame. Now, it looks like on this configuration they don't line up. So I'm going to start at the top here and screw it in. Just snug. no need to over tighten it. So with this one lined up, screw it down just snug. Now, if yours is like this where the holes do not line up, all you need to do is simply look where these bottom holes are and then just drill holes into this bracket here. Now I recommend using, this is a 3/16 drill bit, and I put some tape on here to make a depth stop so that way it can't go through the reflector. You don't want to go through the reflector, it's very thin and there's lamps just on the other side of that. So you need to be careful of that. So you would simply just line it up, drill the hole through the frame on both sides, and then screw those brackets in just like we did here. What we do is with the bi-pin power jumper here from where the original ballast got its power from, we're going to take the black and the white grouping of wires from the new RT ballast, and what we're going to do is just simply connect however your configuration here as well. You're going to end up with one single bi-pin connector, a male, and we just join that to the female here, basically the black to the black and the white to the white. And then I would take, and there's a zip tie in your kit as well. Just simply take that and keep it where this connection is going to stay. Tie it out of the way and tie these together so it stays connected. Now the power is done. What we're going to do is inside your bag, we're going to take out, there's short and long jumpers. There's two long yellow jumpers, and you're going to have four red short jumpers and four yellow short jumpers. We're going to take these like this. If you have only one yellow wire coming out of your ballast, that is just fine. I would put it right here. If you have two, that's great. Then I would put the second one over here. Now, the important thing is that the yellows are just connected at this end. Well, basically it's different than at the red end. If you have one here, then you're going to jump from this one to the other three from there. Since we have two, I'm going to connect it at the first one and at the last one, and then I'm going to jump in between one jumper here and then one jumper there. So I need to strip this wire here. If your wire for some reason isn't stripped, then you just need to strip it back about a quarter of an inch. Exposed wire there. And like I said, I'm going to put it in the fourth one at the end here. And like I said, in this configuration, we're going to jump from this one lamp holder here to the adjacent one next to it. And again, if you had only one yellow coming out of the ballast, you would jump in between all four back here. But since we have two ballasts, we're going to jump from here into the second one, from the first one to the second one here, and then that's it. Now we're going to shunt each lamp holder with the two exposed holes. I prefer the ones on the end. I'm going to take the jumper wires and insert them in the empty holes here just to shunt each one of these out. Now this is the last one here, and then the yellow side is completely done. Okay, and then I'm going to do them here on the red end. I'm going to jump each one of the lamp holders here just like I did on the other side. I'm using the two holes that are closest to the end cap, closest to the end of the bed here. And I'm leaving the holes that are closest to the ballast, and it's important that one is on either side. You don't jump on the same side of the lamp holder like this, you jump on the other side. Now we take each of the four terminations from the red wires, however yours is grouped, and I would put the first one here, basically just one per lamp holder. Put the second one in here. It doesn't matter really which one, it's just one of each goes into one lamp holder. And then now it's completely wired. I'm just going to gather this up here just to keep it out of the way. Just bunch the wires up, the excess. And then that's it.